Okay, we're back. Those chips are good, aren't they? Okay, my next guest is an internationally famous artist who's currently on tour with the Los Angeles Chamber Music Society. His latest recording is on CD called James Galway Plays Nilsson. Would you welcome, please, James Galway. That is so lovely and so beautiful.
Nice piece.
Nice to see you again.
Thank you.
And the young lady on the harp, that's very nice background.
Yep.
Yeah. You make that, like any great art, you make that appear so effortless, you know, and easy to do, but you must constantly have to. What is the embouchure you have to?
Yeah, the embouchure.
The embouchure. So you have to practice constantly?
Yes, all the time.
Yeah.
All the time.
Yeah. We haven't seen you for about, what, two years?
Yeah, three, nearly.
Yeah.
Yeah, I just got married the last time.
That's right. How's it going?
Very, very good. Very well.
Yeah, right. I'm glad. Always glad to hear when somebody's marriage is going well. I like it. Gives us all hope. Does your wife travel with you now all the time when you're
all the time?
Does she used to being on the road?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, she's used to it now, all right.
Yeah. A lot of people don't like that much traveling, and you do a lot of it.
No, I must say I don't like it either. You know, when you get to some place and the bag that contains all your shoes have been lost.
Have you ever lost your instrument?
No.
You must carry that right with you on the plane.
All the time.
So have you showed up someplace but the clothes are gone? You've got a concert, then what do you do?
Well, only one time, actually, and I sort of managed. I played a couple of concerts last season in my sneakers, which was very comfortable, actually. I like that. And nobody notices what you wear on your feet.
Yeah, why not? Why not be comfortable?
Well, I don't know. I mean, people don't look at your feet when you play.
Yeah, Mom, get some nice black sneakers or something and go on out and do it.
I did.
You talked once about when we were on the show about going on the wagon.
Yeah.
Because you were not averse to having an occasional little pick-me-up, right?
True.
And quite a few pick-me-ups here.
Yes.
Did you do it?
Well, after I fell off the wagon a few times, I decided to do something about it eventually, but it came in a roundabout way. I got very overweight, and I decided the only way to deal with this is to go into one of these swanky Swiss clinics where they put you on a diet for 2 weeks and you come out half the man you were. So I did, but at the same time, they have a whole team of doctors, mm-hmm. and they take a reading of everything. And they said to me, well, Mr. Galway, your liver is at the point where if you don't stop, it will not repair itself. And I thought, well, there's no sense to go on with this, and I just stopped.
Now, that's smart, right?
Well, that's what the doctor thought.
Now, I don't want to get letters from Irish people, but the Irish have certainly had a reputation for being pretty good drinkers, right?
Yeah, Why is that?
Is there something in the makeup of the Irish?
I don't know. It's something to do with the Celtic race. You know, the Celts, they all do it. The north of France, where they're the same, you know, they drink this apple cider and stuff like that, and Calvados, and in Wales they do. You know, Dylan Thomas was another example of the Celtic drinking poet.
Right. And we've had a few Irish actors on this show who love to go out and carouse a little bit. I just thought maybe of something in... You're Irish, aren't you?
Yes, I am.
Well, I have to say one thing. For an Irishman, he smells very good.
Well, I'm glad to hear that. You're looking good. You look like you dropped weight, and you look healthy and happy, and that's the main thing. Did you ever think there is a fallacy, is there not, I think, among any creative artist, that sometimes you think when you are under the influence of alcohol, you are performing better, or you're being more creative? I think it's a phony assumption.
It is a phony thing, but I think if you're a writer, it helps, you know, because you know when you drink something, your mind gets a bit muddled. And you begin to sound like James Joyce, you know, because he says one word, then makes a rhyme out of one word. You know, you have pages in Ulysses where it's a rhyme of one word.
Right. You think maybe that he was... I don't know whether it's true or not, Edgar Allan Poe, they said, wrote some of his things under the influence, you know, those macabre type of Poe stories, mm-hmm. when he was under the influence of alcohol. Maybe that's the reason it comes out in that strange way. But the playing, how was it when you were playing? Did you ever...
No, I never drank when I was playing before, always after.
Right.
Because I just can't function at all, you know. If I drink and go and try to play, I mean, it's a hopeless case.
In other words, things don't function right.
No, the old computer doesn't work.
We'll take a break. We'll be right back.